Hey, are you tired of rattly stabilizers? Want to get good sounding stabilizers like the Teha Types kind? Well, I know I do. Fear not. There's two types of people. People who do care about the sound of their keyboards, and people who just really don't. For those who want to improve their keyboard sound, all you've got to do is a simple keyboard mod. According to Desk Authority, yep, there's a wiki wholly dedicated for mechanical keyboards, states keyboard modding, aka keyboard modification, is making a keyboard more to the user's liking, be it in key feel, looks, or sound. So it's like when you get a new keyboard but you don't like the look of the stock keycaps or even the switch feel. Thus, you can mod it by changing the keycaps to other profiles or color. Mod the switches by lubricating it. Some modify the keyboard stabilizers, also known as stabs. Stabilizers keep the longer, bigger keys balanced and prevent over-tilting. So any keycap size 2U and above requires a 2U stab, except for the spacebar, which requires a bigger, longer 7U or 6.25U stab, depending on the layout. So, that rattly stabilizers of yours? Don't fret, you're not stuck with it. All you gotta do is a simple mod to improve it. So far, I realize there's many stabs mods out there. Ones that involve band-aids or holy mod, just using grease lubricants. Some even use seal tape, and others use switch films, aka the Epsi mod. But for this video, I'm gonna show you another way. The cotton pad mod. Initially, I wanted to do the holy mod, but then I realized I ran out of band-aid, so I found the best replacement. Well, cotton pads. I didn't have anything else, so cotton pads it is. Now, here's what you'll need for the cotton pad mod for stabilizers: a cotton pad, a thin brush, and a switch lubricant. The one I'm going for is the Krytox 205 Grade 0. For those that don't have Krytox 205, you can use Permatex, Superlube, or any silicone or dielectric grease as alternatives. First step, take out the stabilizers. Make sure you have clipped and looped both the wire and stab housing. Then take some pieces of cotton, roll it into four small sizes. The secret to not have random lint or flyaways is to douse it with some lube, then just insert the first two small ones inside the front part of the stabs, where the ends of the wire show. Then add the rest of the two small cotton pieces in the top part of the wire where it will have contact with the stem housing. A lot of girls use cotton pads as makeup removers, so if you don't have it, ask any girl out there, I'm sure they might have it. But still, it makes a great alternative for band-aids because you can control the amount and size when putting it in the stabs. So if you want that mushy padded feeling, then put more cotton. If you want less of that, less cotton. Easy. I've never heard of this mod, but I'm just gonna call it as the cotton pad mod for stabilizers. So if you don't like having to take out your stabilizers and disassembling it, you can try the cotton mod as it's shapeable and it doesn't have a fixed thickness like the band-aid does. I tried this on my stubborn space bar that wouldn't just come out, and it worked well. If you're interested to check out my review and sound test on the Techwear Spectre Pro, do check out my full sound test video of it. The link is right here and in the description. So that's all there is to the cotton pad mod. Are you willing to give it a try? Maybe? Still iffy about it? Well, there's nothing wrong with trying something new, right? For me, I like that it's easier to control the amount of padding. And if you know a friend who's obsessed with their stab rattle and can't seem to ignore it, then share this video to them. I mean, it could help them. This mod might or might not work, but I hope you find this video helpful. And if you still have that rattly stabilizer, I'd say just embrace it. Embrace the rattle. Thank you for watching, guys, and don't forget to like. Might be sleep deprived, employee discounts with me.